Hello everyone, and welcome to How-FixIT. In this video guide, I'll show you step-by-step how to install Windows 11 on your laptop or PC. If you need a different version of Windows, check the links in the video description below. First, we need to create a bootable USB drive. You'll need a blank USB flash drive with at least 8 GB of storage. Insert your USB flash drive into your computer, and let's get started. There are two ways to make a bootable USB drive: using the media creation tool or an ISO image file. I'll demonstrate both methods. Click the link in the video description to visit the official Microsoft website and download the media creation tool for Windows 11. Double-click the downloaded file to launch it. Accept the license terms when prompted. You can keep the recommended options or uncheck the box to select a different language. The recommended settings usually work best. Select a USB flash drive as the installation media type. Choose your USB drive from the list and click Next. Wait for the tool to download and create your Windows 11 installation media. Once the process is complete, safely eject the USB flash drive or restart your computer if you are installing Windows on the same system. If Windows 11 is no longer available on the official Microsoft website, you can download the ISO file from archive.org, link provided in the description. This method will also work if you have an OEM version of Windows 11 that comes with your laptop. Additionally, you will need Rufus, link in the description, to create a bootable USB drive. In the Rufus window, ensure your USB drive is selected in the device drop-down menu. Double-check this step to avoid formatting the wrong drive. Under Boot Selection, choose Disk or ISO Image. Click Select and browse to your downloaded Windows 11 ISO file. Once the ISO is loaded, Rufus will apply default settings. For most modern systems, UEFI-based, select Partition Scheme, GPT, and Target System, UEFI, non-CSM. Rufus automatically selects NTFS or FAT32, depending on the ISO file size. Since Windows 11 ISOs can be larger than 4 GB, Rufus may split the files automatically or choose NTFS. Newer versions of Rufus offer additional installation options, such as Remove Requirement for Secure Boot and TPM, Trusted Platform Module. Remove Requirement for an online Microsoft account. These are useful if your PC doesn't meet Windows 11's strict hardware requirements, or if you don't want to sign in with a Microsoft account. In this tutorial, I left these options unchecked to show the standard installation process. And Rufus will warn you that all data on your USB drive will be erased. Rufus will format the USB, extract the ISO contents, and make it bootable. This process may take a few minutes. Once the process is complete, click Close and safely eject your USB drive to prevent file corruption. If you're installing Windows on the same computer, restart it now. When your computer turns on, press F12 to open the boot menu. For some BIOS versions, the key may be F8, F9, F10, Delete, or Escape. In the boot menu, select your USB drive to begin loading the Windows 11 setup files. If you cannot boot from the USB drive, enter your computer's BIOS settings and ensure Secure Boot is enabled and TPM, Trusted Platform Module, is turned on. When the Windows logo appears, wait a few moments for the Windows setup screen. Select your language, time, and currency format, and click Next. Select your keyboard or input method, then click Next. Click Install Windows 11 for a clean installation. Check the agreement box and click Next. If you have a valid Windows 11 product key, enter it now. If you're reinstalling Windows 11 on a device that was previously activated, or if your product key is linked to your Microsoft account, select I don't have a product key. Activation will happen automatically once you're online. Some installations may ask you to select an edition, Home or Pro. Choose the edition that matches your product key. If your laptop's BIOS contains an embedded product key, it is most likely for the Home Single Language Edition. However, if you're unsure which Windows 11 edition to select, consult your laptop manufacturer's support for guidance. Click Next and accept the license terms if you agree. You will see a list of drives and partitions. If you're installing on a new drive, you might see unallocated space. Click Create Partition and specify the size in megabytes for the C drive. Click Apply to create the partition. Windows will create a new primary partition and two additional system partitions. Any remaining unallocated space can be used to create a D drive by selecting Create Partition and applying all remaining space. This way, we have created two partitions, C and D. You can install Windows on one partition, C, and use the other for storing data. I'll allocate the entire disk to the operating system by deleting all existing partitions. You can allocate partitions based on your preferences or install Windows on a single partition. Select the disk where Windows will be installed and click Next. Click Install to begin the installation process. Windows Setup will start copying files. You'll see progress indicators such as copying Windows files and getting files ready for installation. Your computer may restart multiple times during the process. The installation may take several minutes to complete. After the files finish copying, your PC will reboot. Remove the USB drive or change the boot order if your PC tries to boot from the USB again. Windows 11 will ask you to confirm your region. Choose from the list and click Yes. Select your keyboard layout. You can add a second layout if needed or skip this step. Enter a name for your device and click Next. If you're connected by Ethernet, Windows may detect and connect automatically. Otherwise, select your Wi-Fi network and enter the password. Once connected, Windows will download and install the latest updates. Windows 11 typically requires a Microsoft account. Sign in with your email and password. If you don't have an account, click Create One and complete the quick registration process. After signing in, Windows will prompt you to set up a PIN for quick sign-in. Enter and confirm your desired PIN. Adjust your privacy preferences, including location services, diagnostics, and other settings. Turn off anything you don't want to share. Click Accept when done. Select Setup as a new PC and click Next. You may see options to personalize Windows for gaming, creativity, business, etc. Choose if desired or skip. Link your smartphone, Android, or iPhone to your Microsoft account or skip this step. Next, you will be asked to back up your phone's photos to OneDrive, optional. You can skip this. Microsoft Edge settings, choose accept or skip. At this step, you can accept or decline a trial subscription to Microsoft 365 Family, which includes advanced security, cloud storage, office apps, and AI apps. The last step is that you will be asked for a PC Game Pass subscription. Windows 11 will do some final configuration. This may take a few minutes, and that's it. You've successfully installed Windows 11. Make sure Windows is activated. Go to Settings, Open System, then Open Activation and check the activation status. If not activated, enter a valid product key or use the troubleshooter. You can also manually add your product key via your Microsoft account on the Microsoft website. If activation fails, contact Microsoft Support for assistance. And final tip, keep your system up to date. Create a backup schedule and ensure your drivers stay current. If you have any additional questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. Don't forget to check the video description for links to useful resources. Thank you for watching. You are on How Fix It, and I'll see you in the next video.